My first interest in space, if you don't count Star Trek, was the Apollo 11 landing on the moon. I was raised on a farm in rural Iowa. The closest town had 32 people in it, Beaconsfield, Iowa, so it was pretty small. I grew up knowing a lot more cattle and hogs than I did people. Watching everything grow, I think, gave me an interest in science from a very young age. But when Neil stepped onto the moon, it made space real to me. Even as a 9-year-old, I had a recognition for how special this was. I thought, wow, maybe I can go into space. But I was, you know, farm kid, no idea how to figure out how to become an astronaut. When I graduated high school, it was actually really a pivotal moment because that was the year they picked the first female astronauts. And for me, that made my dream a goal because it seemed like something I could do. Luckily, I had no idea how difficult it was going to be. As soon as I finished graduate school, I started applying to become an astronaut. I started working at NASA immediately, but as a scientist and a researcher there. And I was not lucky enough to be selected for the first selection, the second selection, the third selection, the fourth selection. At the time, we heard that the call that we would get would be from the chief of the flight crew operations division. And then if you got the call from the head astronaut, who was Bob Cabana at the time, that you weren't going to be selected. And I got the call, and it was Bob Cabana. And so I was immediately disappointed after, you know, 10 years of trying, and this was the closest I had ever gotten, and I was like, oh, I didn't make it again. And before I got too disappointed, he asked if I could come and work for him. That 10 years of not becoming an astronaut actually gave me a lot of leadership experience and team building experience that later became very valuable for me and was probably part of why I was selected to be commander on the ISS. I was up on board the ISS for a month as the commander before I really kind of understood the significance of it. STS-120 had arrived and Pam Melroy was the commander on the shuttle and I was the commander on the ISS. It was the first time we had two female commanders of two different spacecraft in orbit at the same time. And so that was actually kind of a key moment for me for understanding how significant I was in the role that I was playing. Being in space every single day to me is a special treat. And I think some people get bored with some of the monotony that goes on after being there for months on end. But for me, each day is something that I look forward to, and I'm in space. I'm living my dream. I think space is changing so much right now. And with the paradigms of how we're working in space, it's really exciting. I'm helping engineers who are designing the spacesuit that will be used on the lunar surface when the NASA astronauts walk there. And I'm also helping design the Axiom Space Station, be the first commercial space station in orbit. And it's such an interesting blend that we are going to be working in the future. And it's really exciting to be a part of this changing time.